Hi, I'm Aliya. I'm a New York chef who's passionate about exotic spices, traditions, and places. Welcome to my exotic table.
Traveling and exploring food cultures has always been a love of mine. Not only is it part of how I shape myself as a chef, but I always bring some of that inspiration back to my home. New Orleans has been on my list for a while. As a city that's had its ups and downs not too long ago, I wanted to explore the roots of the Big Easy. So my first stop was the Southern Food and Beverage Museum on the Mississippi Riverfront.
Let me talk a little bit about the difference between Cajun and Creole.
Originally, the Creoles were, and the Creole food was the food of New Orleans. It's a sauce-based food, it's definitely city food, and it's layered in flavor. And it is the amalgam of the enslaved Africans and the Europeans and the Native American food ways. Cajun food was the food of the country. It was one-pot dishes, it was what was available, and often stewed down and everything put into the same pot.
Next up, I wanted to learn some real Louisiana cooking. So I headed to the home of my friend Gwendolyn Scott, who comes from a family of chefs.
So the two dishes that we're gonna do today, one's a crawfish etouffee.
Correct.
And the other one is your gumbo.
Yes.
Okay, and you said you call it seafood gumbo, but it has everything and seafood.
Right. We call it seafood okra gumbo, but it's gonna have crab, shrimp, smoked sausage, and chicken in it.
Okay.
Okay.
Crawfish etouffee and okra gumbo are two seminal dishes in Louisiana cooking. I was so excited to learn them.
We're gonna start with the etouffee.
Okay.
Okay. Now, with my etouffee, I start off, I don't use oil, I use butter.
Sounds good.
Okay. Also, use a couple of these, the scallions
for the
etouffee? Etouffee. Okay. And what I'm gonna do with this, some of this, after we cook it, we're just gonna put it on the top and then serve it.
What would you say are the core spices in this cooking?
Okay, the core spices that we're gonna have today is gonna be the granulated garlic.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna use the bay leaves, the salt, pepper, of course, cayenne.
Cayenne, okay.
That's about it.
Gwen's etouffee had hand-picked crawfish and was rich and creamy. Next was the gumbo.
And with this, basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna saute down the seasoning.
Okay.
And then once that starts cooking a little bit, then you're gonna go ahead and put your smoked sausage in. We're gonna put in the okra, then we're gonna put our stock in. And we're gonna put just a little bit of roux, not much.
Okay.
Okay.
So not a lot.
Not a lot, because
really?
The okra is gonna thicken the gravy itself.
Fresh herbs, some bay leaves, sausage, a little roux. Gwen's gumbo was truly satisfying, and we had a great meal. But I had to save some room for my buddy Carlin Wade's crawfish boil, which I'll have to tell you about another time.
Something that was a little easier to entertain with, a smaller version. So I took what was best about gumbo with what's best about pot pie to create my mini gumbo pot pies. The first thing we're going to do is preheat the oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Now we're going to get working on the roux. I'm going to melt down a stick of butter and add 3/4 cups of flour to it and whisk it. We want to develop a nice dark brown color. And we want to keep whisking throughout the process because we don't want any of it to burn. While that's going, I'm also going to cook my vegetables. Onions, celery, bell peppers, the holy trinity. And I'm also going to throw in a chili because I like the flavor. So I probably don't need this entire thing, so I'll probably use about 3/4 of it and save the rest of it for later. So I'm chopping these up, and like I mentioned, I want to make them pretty small. I want to make everything kind of bite-sized. It'll just help everything cook quicker and it'll work in the little ramekins. Okay. Let's throw in our bell pepper. Continuously checking on your roux. Make sure you're getting the stuff in the sides. You don't want any of that to burn. Now this is my addition. I like a good Fresno pepper. Adds some nice heat to this, so we're gonna throw that in. We need about 2 cups of sliced okra. I cut off the tips and the ends, and I'm slicing them relatively small, smaller than I would for a normal gumbo, because I want them to cook up a little quickly and fit into my little mini pot pies. So now you can see this roux is starting to turn to a nice dark color. It's a little deeper than caramel, and we went at it about milk chocolate. So now I'm just gonna slice up my sausage. Now andouille is fully cooked, so you can eat it like this, and it's spicy. But I like to brown it up in the pan because I just think it tastes better. And I'm gonna throw in my sausage. Our roux is done, sausage is cooked up. I'm gonna add in this garlic, throw in the spices, and we're gonna throw that all into the roux. So the garlic, I can start to smell it. It smells amazing. This whole thing smells amazing. We're about to throw this all in with the roux and get the gumbo really cooking. I'm gonna pour in the chicken stock first, and then add in the vegetables. I wanna make sure that I get all of the roux incorporated and lump-free. First, I'm gonna throw in this. All these cooked down vegetables, the holy trinity, the andouille. Throw that up. About a half cup or so of heavy cream. So now, this is up to temperature. We want to turn it down to a slow simmer and let that simmer for about 15 to 20 minutes, thicken up and get that great gumbo texture. I'm just gonna throw down a little bench flour to make sure that the puff pastry doesn't stick to the surface. I don't want it to be too thin, and we have two pieces, so we'll probably end up rolling out both in order to get eight. This gumbo pot pie fits eight of these ramekins, so we're gonna have eight servings. If you don't have a cutter like me, you can just use your measuring cup or a glass or anything that'll help you cut up the dough. The gumbo is all cooked. It's really thickened up a lot. You can tell the texture, it's a lot thicker. It's gonna thicken up even a little bit more in the oven. When we're baking it, so I don't want to take it too far. So last but not least, I'm going to add in the seafood. The gumbo is cooked, but I don't want the seafood to overcook. And since it's going to be in the oven for another 20 minutes with the puff pastry, I like to put that in last. I also like to throw in the herbs at this point. Green onions, cilantro, and parsley. So I'm going to grab my ladle, we're going to fill these little ramekins with gumbo, top them with the puff pastry, and throw them in the oven. Forgot to say, check it out, the bay leaf's still in there. You don't want to put that bite in your mouth. Remember to take that out. You just want to kind of crimp down the sides. So I'm going to paint them with the egg wash, and then I'm going to poke holes in them to let the steam out. We don't want them to sort of fall off. Now into the oven they go. Don't they look gorgeous? So the gumbo pot pie is done. I can't wait to eat it. The smell is just incredible. It's hot, still fresh out of the oven, but I can't resist it. Like crawfish, shrimp, crab, sausage, it tastes amazing. That buttery puff pastry gives it such a nice finish. Carl, Wade, Gwen, thank you so much. I'm honored to have learned from you guys, and I'm so happy that your influence is a part of my exotic table. So good.